panel, we're going to kind of pick up a bit where we left off at our intro panel yesterday, go over some raids info, questing info, gameplay, and other systems that we didn't get to talk about yesterday, and then we'll have some time for question and answer right after that. So let me just jump right into this. I want to talk a little bit more about the raid content that we're going to have in Warlords of Draenor. So yesterday I mentioned the Blackrock Foundry raid. This is going to be the capstone of the raid content that we launched the expansion with. As I mentioned, we're going to try to repeat the two-tier system that we had in Mists of Pandaria, where we have that sort of smaller intro tier that's available right away to kind of whet your appetite for raiding, as most of the world is still leveling and gearing up and getting ready for that. And then a few weeks after that, we unlock, you know, sort of the real centerpiece of the intro expansion content, and that's going to be the Blackrock Foundry. Now, this is the center of the Iron Horde war machinery in the Zone of Gorgrond. It's going to be a 10-boss raid and non-linear layout. We have heard you guys, we miss Old War II, we miss Isochron Citadel, that type of layout. There's a lot to be said for delivering both an epic raid.
And so does one other guy.
Exactly. Just that one guy, though. There's a lot to be said for delivering an epic raid in terms of scope, but also giving you the freedom to kind of work your way through a place more organically instead of just proceeding from boss 1 to 2 to 3 to 4. It's also nice to be able to choose what you're going to progress on and so forth. So we're happy to do that. And your goal here is going to be to dismantle the Blackrock Foundry from the inside, tear down the war-making capabilities of the Iron Horde, and face off against Warlord Blackhand, who is the chieftain of the Blackrock Orcs and heads up the Foundry as a whole. Now, this is a concept illustrating just kind of the general vibe we're going for here. Really just a lot of, you know, this is smoke and soot and flame and dark iron. That's what the Iron Horde's all about. That's what their machinery is all about. Now, this is a temp, this is a sort of overall layout in 2D of what we're looking at for the structure of the raid as a whole. And you see there are three wings here. There is sort of the first wing, which is mostly about melting down the ore into slag. Second wing, where that molten ore is forged and refined and shaped into weapons, armor, the engines of war. And then finally, an assembly wing, where all of that is put together, soldiers are armored up, the war machines are shipped off to the front lines. Now, we want to put this together really as something that has a very functional feel to it. This isn't, you know, a place that was designed as a raid zone, this is a place that was designed as a foundry. And we want to get back to some of that interconnectedness that you got as you walk through old places like Upper Blackrock Spire or Blackrock Depths, where you can kind of look down and see the other parts of the zone going on around you. So just because you see this 2D layout where everything is spread out in different directions, that's really more just to kind of help us in our conceptualization of the zone. But the thought is three separate wings, and then once you've cleared all of these wings, you can access the crucible that you see at the top of this layout where Blackhand himself awaits. Now, part of what we'd like to do in having nonlinear layouts is also really preserve some of the freedom that players currently doing flexible mode may be used to in how they approach the zone. Right? If you're doing Siege of Orgrimmar today, at this point, if you want to just queue up and face off against Garrosh directly, you can do that if you're doing flexible. Now, with our new raid structure, it's going to be something that you just zone in the front door for instead of queuing, but we want to preserve some of that freedom. So we envision some things such as maybe once you've cleared all the wings a certain number of times, maybe you can forge a key that lets you directly access the crucible later on, if your raid leader has that ability, so that you don't necessarily have to feel like if you have to re-clear 9 bosses just to get to the 10th every time. And in general, you have as much freedom and be able to plan your raid week the way you want.